Hi everyone, welcome back to Dentizen. Today we are here with a new video. We are going to continue our important topic of dental histology, that is tooth development. We have already covered this topic in previous videos where we have discussed the basics of the tooth development, the names of the different morphological stages of the tooth development. We have also discussed each morphological stage, that is bud stage, gap stage and bell stage in detail. We have also discussed the root formation in detail. So the links for all these videos can be found in the description box below. In today's video, we are going to discuss the last heading of this topic, that is physiological stages of tooth development, which can be your important theory and viva question. So let's begin. So before we start, I want you to quickly subscribe to Dentizen and also hit on the bell icon so that you remain notified about new videos. Now, tooth development is a continuous process. That means it keeps on happening without breaks. Then how will we understand it? So for study purposes, we divide this process into morphological stages, which is based on the morphology. That means the shape of the enamel organ. So on this basis, we have bud stage, gap stage, early bell stage, and late or advanced bell stage. But then in this tooth development process, certain physiological processes are also happening. So based on the underlying physiological mechanism, we have five physiological stages. These are: first one is initiation, that is when the tooth formation is initiated, when start hota hai. Second is proliferation, when in these started areas the cells, they proliferate, they divide to form new cells. Third is the histodifferentiation, when these cells, they stop dividing and they start to differentiate. That means they acquire a particular shape and function, that is called histodifferentiation. And the fourth stage is morpho differentiation, when it is determined that what type of tooth is going to form, whether it is going to be an incisor, a canine, a premolar or a molar, so that the basic size and the form of the future tooth is established in morpho differentiation. And the last stage is apposition, in which these hard tissues, that is enamel and dentine, are deposited, and they are deposited in layers. So these are the five physiological stages: initiation, proliferation, histodifferentiation, morpho differentiation and apposition. Now these stages are overlapping. That means in any one particular morphological stage, we can say many physiological processes going together. Ek hi stage mein bahut sare physiological processes ikatthe chalte rehte hain. So these stages are overlapping. So in this video, we are going to see each physiological stage in detail. हम हर physiological stage को detail में देखने वाले हैं और ये भी देखने वाले हैं कि वो physiological process कौन कौन सी morphological stage में हो रहा है. So let's start with the first stage, that is initiation. Initiation का मतलब है beginning, start होना. तो tooth development की beginning कब होती है? जब हमारा oral ectoderm नीचे को प्राइमरी एपिथेलियल बैंड बनाता है. जैसा कि हमने फर्स्ट वीडियो में देखा था, बेसिक्स ऑफ टूथ डेवलपमेंट, दिस बैंड विल डिवाइड इनटू टू, वेस्टिबुलर लमाइना एंड डेंटल लमाइना. वेस्टिबुलर लमाइना तो वेस्टिबुल बना देगा, लेकिन जो डेंटल लमाइना है वो हमारा टूथ बनाएगा. सो डेंटल लमाइना एक्ट्स एज द प्राइमोडियम ऑफ टूथ एंड दिस इज द फर्स्ट स्ट्रक्चर इन द टूथ डेवलपमेंट. सो दिस हॉर्सशू शेप्ड डेंटल लमाइना, which is one horseshoe shape structure in maxilla and one in mandible, in the specific regions in this structure where the cells have the potential, initiation will start. So all teeth are not initiated at same time. Sare teeth ikatthe initiate nahi hote. The first ones to initiate is in the mandibular anterior region. और ये initiation process कैसे शुरू होता है, कैसे epithelial cells को पता चलता है कि उनको dental lamina बनाना है? This happens by a mechanism which is known as epithelial mesenchymal interaction. That means जो हमारे oral cavity का ectoderm है, उसके cells को signal मिलता है नीचे के ectomesenchymal cell से, और signal मिलने पर ही वहाँ पे initiation start होता है, dental lamina formation start होता है. So we can say that the first stage, initiation stage, corresponds with the formation of dental lamina, which is a horseshoe shaped structure. Different teeth initiated at different times, and initiation occurs by epithelial ectomesenchymal interaction. Inki signaling hoti hai aapas mein. Agar inke beech mein signals na transfer ho, ये एक दूसरे को सिग्नल्स ना दें, एक्टोडर्म को सिग्नल नहीं मिले, तो वहाँ पे तो इनिशिएशन नहीं होगा ना. सो यस, देयर कैन बी लैक ऑफ इनिशिएशन. फॉर एग्जांपल, इन दिस रीजन इफ देयर इज लैक ऑफ इनिशिएशन, तो लैटरल इंसाइजर विल नॉट फॉर्म. सो दिस, देयर इज अ टर्म फॉर दिस. देन व्हेन देयर इज लैक ऑफ इनिशिएशन, वी कॉल इट एनोडोंशिया. एनो मीन्स नो, डोंशिया मीन्स टूथ. सो देयर इज अ मिसिंग टूथ, एब्सेंस ऑफ टूथ. मोस्ट कॉमनली इट इज सीन इन मैक्सिलरी लैटरल इंसाइजर, followed by the third molars and then mandibular second premolar. So that can be your entrance question, the most commonly seen missing tooth. And if there is extra initiation, normally we have 32 permanent teeth. Agar extra ban jaye, so that is called supernumerary. Numerary means number, super means more. So more than normal number is called supernumerary teeth. And what if this initiation occurs in some other location? नॉर्मली हमारे माउथ में बनते हैं ना टीथ. सो समटाइम्स इट कैन बी सीन फॉर्मिंग इन ओवरीज. सो दैट कैन बी द एबनॉर्मल इनिशिएशन एट अ डिफरेंट लोकेशन. सो ऑल दीज आर द थिंग्स विच कैन बी सीन इफ समथिंग गोज रॉन्ग एट इनिशिएशन, दैट इज एनोडोंशिया, सुपरन्यूमरी टीथ एंड टीथ अराइजिंग इन ओवरी. नाउ वी कम टू द सेकेंड स्टेज, दैट इज प्रोलिफरेशन. अब प्रोलिफरेशन मीन्स डिवीजन ऑफ सेल्स. तो ये सेल डिवीजन वहीं पे होगा जहाँ पे हमारा इनिशिएशन स्टार्ट हुआ था. सो विद द प्रोलिफरेशन ऑफ द सेल्स, द शेप ऑफ दिस बर्ड विल चेंज इनटू कैप शेप स्ट्रक्चर एंड इट विल फाइनली गो टू बेल शेप स्ट्रक्चर इन अर्ली बेल स्टेज एंड देन इट विल बी इन द लेट बेल स्टेज. बट लेट बेल स्टेज में जाके सेल्स की डिवीजन रुक जाती है, सेल्स स्टॉप डिवाइडिंग एंड दे गेट डिफ्रेंशिएटेड, अमीलोब्लास्ट और ओडोंटोब्लास्ट सेल्स बन जाते हैं. सो वी कैन से दैट प्रोलिफरेशन is not seen in late bell stage, but it is seen in bud stage, cap stage and early bell stage. So proliferation occurs at the points of initiation, jahan jahan pe initiation hua tha wahan pe cells ki proliferation hoti hai. And because of this proliferation there is change in the size and proportion of the tooth germ. Tooth germ ka size or shape change ho jata hai, wo bud se cap se bell shape structure mein change ho jata hai. Now can something go wrong with proliferation? Ho sakta hai na. अगर हमारा ये इनामल ऑर्गन एक्सीडेंटली इन्वेजिनेट कर जाए, अंदर को चला जाए, सो वी कैन से डेपोजिशन ऑफ इनामल लाइक दिस एंड डेपोजिशन ऑफ डेंटिन बिलो इट. सो हमें ऐसा लग सकता है कि एक टूथ अंदर को बना हुआ है और एक बाहर को. सो इट कैन गिव एन अपीयरेंस ऑफ अ टूथ इनसाइड अ टूथ, टूथ विद इन अ टूथ. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड डेंस इनवेजिनेटस. डेंस हेयर इज रेफरिंग टू टूथ, इन्वेजिनेटस अंदर को घुसा हुआ. सो डेंस इन्वेजिनेटस. अब इसका ऑपोजिट भी हो सकता है कि इनामल ऑर्गन कैन प्रोट्रूड आउटसाइड अलॉन्ग विद द डेंटल पैपिला. सो देयर कैन बी फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ग्लोब्यूल शेप स्ट्रक्चर और एक्सेसरी कस्प लाइक स्ट्रक्चर. एक एक्स्ट्रा हमें ग्लोब्यूल शेप का स्ट्रक्चर दिखेगा टूथ के सर्फेस पे. एंड दैट इज कॉल्ड डेंस इवेजिनेटस. नाउ समटाइम्स अ सिंगल टूथ जर्म can be trying to divide into two, so which are completely or incompletely separated. So this is called gemination. Cells aise proliferate kar rahe hain ki ek tooth germ do mein divide hone ki koshish kar raha hai. Sometimes there are two tooth germs and they are trying to fuse. दो टूथ जर्म्स हैं और वो fuse करके एक बनने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं. So which can be complete or incomplete fusion. So that can also occur with the disturbance in proliferation. So second stage, proliferation stage, if something goes wrong, it can lead to dense invaginators, gemination of teeth and fusion of teeth. Now we come to the third stage. Third stage means histodifferentiation. That succeeds proliferation. जहाँ जहाँ पे cells proliferate हो गए, उसके बाद उनकी cell division रुक जाएगी और cells differentiate हो जाएंगे. So it is said that histodifferentiation starts in the cap stage, जहाँ पे हमें columnar shape के cells बनने शुरू दिखने लगते हैं. They become more columnar in the bell stage and they become tall columnar, properly differentiated ameloblast cells and odontoblast cells in late bell stage. So late bell stage mein there is peak, highest development of histodifferentiation, peak pe pahunch jata hai. So we can say that histodifferentiation is not seen in bud stage, but it is seen in cap stage, early bell stage and late bell stage. So it succeeds proliferation. In by histodifferentiation, formative cells are formed, that is ameloblast and odontoblast, which are morphologically and functionally distinctive. दिखने में morphology में अलग से हैं, function भी उनका अलग सा तय हो गया है. And they do not divide, their mitotic activity stops, ceases. Now can something go wrong with histodifferentiation? अगर ये हमारे amyloblast or odontoblast properly na bane to kya hoga? So it can lead to amylogenesis imperfecta, that means enamel which is not properly formed, and then it can also lead to dentinogenesis imperfecta, dentin which is not properly formed. Now sometimes in cases of vitamin A deficiency where these odontoblast cells may not properly differentiate, so we can see a type of dentin formation which is referred to osteodentin. Osteo means bone. So bone ke jaisa dentin banega, and that is seen in vitamin A deficiency. So these can be the problems occurring with the histodifferentiation, amylogenesis imperfecta, dentinogenesis imperfecta and osteodentin occurring in vitamin A deficiency. Now we come to the fourth stage, that is morpho differentiation. So hereby the basic form and the relative size of the future tooth is established. So this occurs by differential growth. That means agar hamare sare cells ek hi type se divide karte rehte to ye to hamara round shape ka structure ban jata, but sare cells hamare same rate pe divide nahi karte. Kuch cells jaldi divide karte hain, kuch cells dheere divide karte hain. So because of which the shape will change, like cap shape structure, bell shape structure, and that is how the crown shape is determined. So we can say that morpho differentiation occurs because of the differential growth of the cells. That means different rates pe cell divide kar rahe hain, because of which the morpho differentiation happens. So it cannot occur without the proliferation, kyunki cells divide kar rahe hain, proliferate kar rahe hain different rates. So proliferation ke saath saath hi hamara morpho differentiation ho raha hai, and it begins at the future dentino enamel junction. Jo hamara dentino enamel junction jahan pe future junction banna hai, wahan pe hamare ye cell jo hai sabse pehle differentiate honge, aur wahin pe hamara sabse pehle enamel aur dentin banna shuru hoga. So that is dentino enamel junction, and in case of root it is dentino cemental junction where that is dentin and cementum will be formed. So we can say that these two junctions, that is dentino enamel junction and dentino cemental junction, they act as the blueprint pattern of the tooth. So we can say that morpho differentiation establishes the form and size of future tooth. It occurs by differential growth, cells are dividing at different rate, and it is impossible without proliferation. Proliferation ke saath saath hi hota hai. And dentino enamel junction and dentino cemental junction, they act as blueprint jahan pe hamara differentiate honge amyloblast, odontoblast, cementoblast, and they will lay down their respective heart tissues, and that will give the proper size and form of the tooth. So can anything go wrong with morpho differentiation? Sometimes we can see egg shaped lateral incisors. We can also see small size teeth which is known as microdontia, and we can see large size teeth which are known as macrodontia. Now morpho differentiation is occurring along with the proliferation. So the disturbances in proliferation can correspond with disturbances in the morpho differentiation state. Now we come to the fifth stage, that is apposition stage. So in this stage, heart tissues, that is enamel and dentin matrix, they are deposited. They are deposited in layers by the cells. That means they occur as additive growth. Ek layer banta hai, uske upar dusra layer add hota hai, fir teesra layer add hota hai. So it occurs in layers, and it occurs by additive growth. Which occurs in regular and rhythmic deposition, that is regular intervals pe hota hai. So the cells, that is amyloblast cells and odontoblast cells, which are depositing enamel and dentin, they will form a layer, then they will take rest. Again they will form a layer, again they will take rest. Again they will form a layer, again they will take rest. So it occurs in alternate periods of activity and rest. So amyloblast and odontoblast cells lay down these hard tissues in layers. Now, can something go wrong in this? Yes, we have read that it occurs in two steps. Hard tissues form in two steps, matrix and mineralization. Agar matrix proper na ho, then it can lead to hypoplasia, enamel hypoplasia. And if there is something wrong with mineralization, it can lead to enamel hypocalcification. So either of these things can occur, or both of these things can occur together, that is enamel hypoplasia and enamel hypocalcification. So that occurs in the fifth stage, that is apposition stage, disturbances in the apposition stage. Now apart from these physiological and morphological stages, there is one important point related to tooth development, that is When our heart tissues are formed, हमारा enamel और dentin जब बन चुका है, crown पे पहुंच चुका है, what happens to enamel organ? ये जो हमारा enamel organ था, जिसके अंदर पहले चार layers थी bell stage में, अब वो enamel organ हमारा compress हो जाता है, reduced हो जाता है, और उसकी layers indistinctive हो जाती है, उनमें difference नहीं रहता, सारे एक जैसे दिखने लगते हैं, and this is known as reduced enamel epithelium. This is called reduced enamel epithelium. This reduced enamel epithelium remains over the newly formed crown, जो अभी अभी हमारा crown बना है, जिसमें enamel और dentin crown completion हो चुका है, उसके ऊपर ये layer रहती है, और तब तक रहती है जब तक ये हमारा tooth erupt नहीं होता. So reduced enamel epithelium keeps covering this crown of newly formed crown till it erupts in the mouth, till the tooth erupts in the mouth. So it protects this crown till that time. अब इसका आगे क्या रोल है और ये क्यों रहता है, हम आगे के टॉपिक्स में पढ़ने वाले हैं. सो दैट इज़ ऑल अबाउट द फाइव फिजियोलॉजिकल स्टेजेस एंड हाउ दे कॉरेस्पॉन्ड विद द मॉर्फोलॉजिकल स्टेजेस एंड व्हाट प्रॉब्लम्स कैन व्हाट डिस्टर्बेंसेस कैन अकर इन. नाउ लेट्स डू अ क्विक रिकैप. सो द मॉर्फोलॉजिकल स्टेजेस आफ्टर डेवलपमेंट आर बड स्टेज, गैप स्टेज, अर्ली बेल स्टेज एंड लेट बेल स्टेज. फाइव फिजियोलॉजिकल स्टेजेस आफ्टर डेवलपमेंट आर इनिशिएशन, प्रोलिफरेशन, हिस्टो डिफरेंशिएशन, मॉर्फो डिफरेंशिएशन एंड एपोजिशन. So initiation corresponds with the formation of dental lamina, proliferation corresponds with the bud stage mein dikhta hai, also seen in gap stage and it is also seen in early bell stage. So that is the proliferation. If we talk about the histo differentiation, it is seen in gap stage, then it is also seen in early bell stage and it reaches its peak in late bell stage. And if we talk about the morpho differentiation, so morpho differentiation can occur in all the stages and it goes along with the proliferation, so it can be seen in all the stages. And if we talk about the apposition, it refers to the formation of enamel and dentin in layers. So we have also seen that what can be the clinical considerations in initiation, it can be anodontia, formation of supernumerary teeth and formation of teeth inside the ovaries. Along with the proliferation, there can be dense evaginators, gemination and fusion. In histodifferentiation, there can be amelogenesis imperfecta, dentinogenesis imperfecta and osteodentin seen in vitamin A deficiency. Then in cases of morpho differentiation, then we can have peg-shaped lateral incisors, we can have microdontia and macrodontia. Then in the apposition, we can have enamel hypoplasia and enamel hypocalcification. So those are the different morphological stages, physiological stages and their clinical considerations. So that is all for this video. Let's quickly check what have you learned. Name the five physiological stages of tooth development. Then name the morphological stages in which the following physiological mechanisms occur. That initiation corresponds with what? Proliferation is seen in which all morphological stages? Histodifferentiation is seen in which all morphological stages? Morpho differentiation is seen in which all morphological stages? And apposition corresponds with what? So that is all for this video. If you have understood the physiological stages, you really like the video, do tap on the like button, share the link of this video with your friends and also hit on the bell icon so that you remain notified about new videos. Keep reading, keep studying. Good luck for your exams. See you in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.